Hello friend, welcome back to my lecture on applet and GUI. And in continuation of the previous lecture, in this lecture I am describing about loading images and loading sound on applet, and as well as playing of the sound. So these are the two steps. First step, to load image or sound file. And in step number two, display or play the sound file. This is the program which is related to this image loading and then displaying the image. So you can see here the step number one, to load the image, and step number two, display the image. So you can see the program is started by the import java.applet.star and import java.awt.star. So always we will write these two statements, importing of applet as well as Java, applet as well as AWT, and these two statements are common in case of Java applet. And then we will start public class myapplet1, and it is extended by the applet class. So it is applet package and it is applet class. So now you can see here we have defined one object of image class. So this image class is inside the import, inside the applet we have been this image class, and we are defining object of this image class. And this is init function. This is just like a constructor in the applet, init function. And inside init function we are writing get image function and get document base, and the name of image file is bottom dollar dot jpg. So this is the name of image file, and the get document base will access the image file from the directory. So I will discuss about this get document base in next slide. So it will retrieve this file from the current directory. So we have retrieved the file and from the current directory, and by using this get image function, and the object of this reference of this is im, and the background of the window will be color dot yellow. And then we have written here public void paint graphics g, and inside this we have written g dot draw image, and the image reference is im. So we are drawing this image im image here, g dot draw image im at the 50-50 position. 50 x and y coordinate are 50 and 50, and we'll write here this keyword. This this is the object of the same class, or inside the same program, this is the object of the same program. So we'll display this image. So this is the end of applet code. So it is started from here and it is closed here. So this is to display the image. And now you can see get document base, and the another function is get code base. There are two functions here, get document base and get code base. So what are these functions? You can see here, basically applet needs to explicitly load media or text file. So Java will allow applet to load data from the directory holding the HTML file. Means in case of the applet, we require one class file as well as Java file, Java that is converted to class file, and we require one supporting HTML file by which we can execute the applet. So here we have written the applet needs explicitly load media and text, and Java will allow applet to load data from directory holding HTML file that started the applet, the document base that started the applet. So it is called and document base, HTML file that started the applet. So for HTML file we require document base and the directory from which the applet class file will be loaded, that is called code base, get code base. So we require here get code base as well as get document base. You can see here get document base, we have written here get, D is capital and B is also capital. Get document base is a function. So for requiring this applet file as well as HTML file, we use this get document base and get code base. So these directories are written as a URL. So these are written, these functions are, will return the URL. So you can see here, this is the first line, import java.awt.start, then import java.applet.start, and then import java.net. So in case of networking, we require this net.start. So now see the applet program. Applet code bases width 300, height 50, and applet is closed here. So bases is the name of the class. So applet code is bases. So whatever the, so in this case, the name of applet program, applet class, it will be myapplet1.class. So we'll write here myapplet1.class. In this case, we'll write here myapplet1.class. So I can write here myapplet1.class. myapplet1. So class, there is no need to, by default it is class file. So now again see this statement, Java will allow applet to load data from directory holding HTML file. So directory which is hold, which is having this HTML file, and started the applet, which started the applet, get document base function is required for that, and directory from which the applet class file is loaded, where applet class file is having, it will loaded from which directory, that directory will call code base directory. So these directory will return as a URL. So it will return the URL. So now you can see here publish class, we have to change this, we can change the name of class also here. So public class, this is basis extend applet. So we must have to change the name of class also. So in this case, it should be basis should be here. So I have changed it, but it should be basis. So as the name of class, the name of applet will be here. So both must be same. So this is the class and this is public void paint graphics G, and inside string message is there, and then we have written here URL get code base. So get code base that will return and directly from which applet class file was loaded. So it means get code base will return where name of the directory where applet class is stored, means it will return the applet class file, the directory name where applet class file is loaded. So this is the statement, and URL is the variable. This is the type of URL because we have imported here import java.net.star. So that's why we are writing here URL, and it's a variable URL. So it may be U also, it may be R also. Anything we can write the variable name of this URL class. So this is the get code base, and message equals to code base and URL.toString, and this URL which we have collected here, we have retrieved here, and this will be converted into a string, and code base will be displayed. So you can see the output of this one in the next window. You can see the output. The code base equals to file colon slash h colon java, means inside java directory we have, inside java directory you can see here, inside java directory applet class file was loaded, that is get code base. So applet class file is inside java. You can see here applet class file is inside h directory, and java is inside the h directory. So we'll having this Java directory where we have applet class file. So this is the program. This is the output of the program. And now you can also see the second one. So this is displayed at g.drawstring message means whatever is inside this message variable, it will display in 10, 20 location. This is x and y position, x and y coordinate, where we are displaying this message variable. And the second statement, again we are writing here URL equals to get document base, and like get code base, we are writing here URL equals to get document base. Get document base means the HTML file that is started the applet, holding the directory, holding the HTML file. So it will return the directory where HTML file is having. So it will return the directory name where this HTML file is stored. So it will be again URL dot to string, we will convert it into string, and document base equals to will display that URL, and it will be displayed at 10 comma 40 position. X is 10 and Y is 40. So G dot by G dot draw string, we can display it at this position. So HTML file is inside bases. So we have these two output, and the output of the first get document base and get code base. So both output are given here, get document base, and first one is the get code base and the second one is the get document base. So now the next program where we are playing the audio. So in this program we are writing here import java.applet.star and import java.awt.star, and public class my applet sound extend applet, and we have written here audio clip AC. So in the previous program we have written image, we have written image im. Here you can see image im. Im is the object of image class. So but in this program we have been this audio clip. This is audio clip. AC is object of audio clip, and public void init is the first program, first function. This is just like a constructor function. And again we are writing here get audio clip, get document base, and this is the .au extensions file. So au is the audio file. So this is audio file. So you can see again the same program, get image. Get image, here we are writing inside NIT get image, and in this program we are writing get audio clip. In the previous program we are writing get image, here we are writing get audio clip, and then get document base, and then we are writing this name of this audio file, and it is started by NIT and it is closed by this curly bracket, and it is closed by curly bracket. Then we have written here a start function, while in the previous program we are not writing any start function because we don't require to start the image, but we have to start the audio. Only image will be only displayed here. So here we are writing g dot draw image, while in this program we are writing this not draw image. We are draw audio, we cannot write here draw audio. We will start the audio. So we have this start function, and in the start function we will write here ac dot loop. So this audio clip will be started here, and it will be audio will be started here, and it will be stopped by stop function. So start and stop function are required in applet for this type of program. So public void stop is a stop function, and predefined function this is also, and inside this stop function we are stopping the audio. So we have started audio from here, by loop function we have started the audio, and by stop function we have closed or stopped the sound, and stop the sound upon leaving this web page. So this is the program, and we don't require any public static void paint. We don't require any paint function here. In this case public void paint graphics G is required in case of the image, while in case of the sound we don't require any public void paint because we are not drawing anything, we are playing the sound. So this is the difference. So we require here start and stop function. So we have been lots of function in Java applet. So all the function are required and used according the uses. So here we require start and stop function. So thank you guys, thank you very much for listening this lecture.